Good evening. This is our second evening mass, ating simbang gabi, pangalawang gabi ngayon. I don't know kung pwede na bang mag-greet sa inyo. Merry Christmas, where we are still preparing our Christmas celebration. The last part of the gospel today says, "What I say to you, I say to everyone, watch, watch, watch." I don't know kung paano yan i-translate in Tagalog. Parang magantay, magbabantay, o ano ba, be vigilant. Anyway, ang ating gospel ngayon, medyo siya may pagkamalalim at medyo may pagka-theological, pero gagawa natin ng paraan na maiintindihan at maiuwi natin siya pabaon ang salita ng Diyos na mapagnilay-nilayan at mai-apply natin sa ating sarili. Okay? May mga bagay-bagay na dapat natin iintindihin, especially itong part na may mga pananaw ang ating Panginoon sa mga bagay-bagay na mangyayari sa Jerusalem, ang nangyayari, it has been misinterpreted, misled into some other points. So, i-clarify natin ang mga bagay-bagay na ito ngayon. Again, itong ating pangalawang simbang gabi. Okay? So, unang-una, he was talking about the fig tree. At ginawa niya itong parang analogy na ang isang kahoy na fig tree, assuming na ang lahat ng mga audience niya that time ay nakakaintindi. Pero for us, kailangan natin i-explain ito. Ano bang ipinapahiwatig ng ating Panginoon sa ginagamit niyang analogy ang fig tree sa ating lahat ngayon, sa ating ebanghelyo? First, when you see a fig tree na sa tingin nyo na yung mga dahon ay nahuhulog na, nalaya sa Bisaya, and it is sending a message to all na nakaka-observe, nakakita that the climate or the weather condition is about to change. That's number one point in his analogy, using the fig tree. Number two, it pictures out to them, or to us today, na death and dying is part of the process of a fig tree. In order for a fig tree to move on, keep on living, it has to go through a process of dying. It is as if he's about to die. But actually, parang si, ano siya ito? Para itong actor sa movies natin nga, parang actor papatay-patay sa first stage ng paglabas sa mga pelikula. Parang si FPJ, yung first stage, papatay-patay, ang actor, yun pala, buhay. Because dying is part and parcel of the process of a tree for it to produce fruit and fruits of plenty. So merong dying process noon. Okay? And thirdly, it pictures out to us that after it dies, it will live again. Okay? So yun yung introductory parts na dapat natin alamin. Paano ba natin i-connect itong tatlo sa pinaka-essence ng ating gospel ngayon? Okay? Jesus, sabi nga ng iba, nakakatakot naman yung gospel ngayon. Nakakatakot kasi, yan, parang foretelling of the things to come. That's why we need to prepare. Pero atong pag-prepare, dapat alam natin up to what extent ba ang ating vigilance, ang ating paghahanda. Dahil importante sa atin ano ba ang pinaghahandaan natin. Sino ba ang darating? Okay? So, nitong points ng gospel natin ngayon, meron akong i-share sa inyong tatlong points nito ngayon. Number one, yung misconception ng iba that Jesus knew about the end of time, that Jesus knew about the end of the world. Okay? I-clarify natin ito. Jesus was not projecting or foreseeing the end of time event. He was not talking about the end time event or end of the world event. Jesus was talking about the destruction of Jerusalem and the destruction of the Jerusalem temple. Yun, klaro yan. Kasi minensyon na dito, nakakatakot, mga pangyayari na dapat paghahandaan. And yung event na ito, tapos na to. Okay ba? Nangyari na, nagkatotoo, Jerusalem Temple was destroyed during 70 AD. Okay? And then, ano bang nangyari? Aside from the destruction of Jerusalem Temple, na-destroy din ang kabuuang city of Jerusalem. And there were so much suffering, pain and suffering, atrocities experienced by the first Christians. Okay? Number two, Jesus says that he does not know the day or the hour when these things come. Ano ibig sabihin ito? Ibig sabihin ito, Jesus also did not foretell. Jesus also did not forewarn us na alam niya kung kailan ang actual, totoong panahon na ito ay mangyayari. No, hindi yan ang sinasabi niya. He was talking about his second coming or talking about the second coming, pero hindi niya tinumbok ang actual time kung kailan ang pagdating niya muli. Underline that. Hindi niya sinasabi iyon. Okay? Number two, Jesus says that he does not know the day or the hour when he will come again. Hindi niya tinumbok na alam niya kung kailan ang kanyang muling pagdating. There can be no greater warning and rebuke to those who work out dates and timetables as to when he will come again. Ibig sabihin, last part nitong gospel ni Mark, ang mention doon, ang sinasabi ni Jesus was that nobody knows when this exact time comes. Ulit. Siguraduhin natin. Nobody knows when the exact time when he comes again. Nobody knows. Even the angels of God, even himself, the Son of Man, only God the Father knows all this, when all these things is going to happen into our midst. Kaya, huwag tayong basta-basang naniniwala sa mga pinagsasabi na may giyera, ano ba, may kalamidad, may bagyo, may lindol. Itong lahat ay pagpapahiwatig na babalik na si Jesus. Ito ang katapusan ng panahon. And so on and so forth. No, even Jesus himself, only God the Father knows. Ang ibig sabihin nito, we'll go to number three, point number three. Point number three is how important is our preparation for the Lord's coming. Napaka-importante pala ang paghahanda nitong 4 weeks of Advent at itong preparation nating Novena Mass every night, dahil it's still part and parcel of our preparation of the coming of the Lord. Ano bang meron sa iyang coming? Immediately, it's Christmas. Christmas is not it is not something new. Christmas is about reenactment, remembering, and celebrating the first coming of the baby Jesus into our world, into us. That's why every Christmas is a reenactment of what happened during the first. That's the immediate preparation of our Advent, that right after Advent, it's Christmas season. It's Christmas celebration. Dahil nangyari na. Binabalik-balik natin year after year. We celebrate Christmas. We rejoice. We are grateful. We thank the Lord for His coming to us. But after Christmas, beyond Advent and beyond Christmas, is our actual preparation. Yan ang sinasabi ko palagi. Every day is a day of preparation. Because nobody knows the exact time when Jesus comes back to us. What will happen? Alam natin ito. For those who had been faithful, who believe and follow Jesus in all His commandments, His final coming. So, ang ating paghahanda is that every day is a day of preparation. Because beyond Christmas season, beyond this Advent season, and Christmas season, is our real life experience of preparation and vigilance. Because nobody knows the exact time, He says. Nobody knows the exact time when He comes to us again. What is sure is that for those who have been faithful, followed all the commandments of the Lord, and those who have been faithful in His teachings, His final coming is joy and rejoicing to all of us. It's the promise of heaven being fulfilled. But for those until this time who continually reject and turn down the invitation of the Lord Jesus, it's for us a disaster. Hence, ang araw-araw na paghahanda, any moment of the day, is part of our Christian life or Christian living. Because we know God is coming. God is coming to town. But nobody knows exactly the time when He comes again. When He comes, to conclude, I would like God to find us, that our work, our mission is completed. Being a priest, being a father, dapat may nagawa tayong accomplishment sa pagbalik niya. Number two, I would like God to find me, to find us when He comes, that we are reconciled to each other, that we are comfortable to each other, that we come one united again as children of God. Nagkakaisa. Nagkakaroon ng reconciliation ng bawat isa. Nagkakaroon ng support, love, care ang bawat isa. Why? That's expected from us as Christian community, as God's children. Lastly, I would like God to find me, to find us, that I am comfortable, I am at peace with God Himself. Simple lang ang sharing ko nito. I don't know, I-share ko na sa inyo ito before. I would like God to find me, thirdly, that I am at peace with God Himself, Jesus. Because the only person who would accompany us in this travel, in this journey towards eternity, is Jesus. And I cannot just imagine this Jesus, the only person who will accompany me in my journey, is an enemy. Enemy because I was not able to reconcile with Him while I was still alive and preparing for His coming. So I'll make sure, we make sure that this Jesus is a friend of ours. Because for sure, I would like to journey with Him in an intimate conversation and relationship with Him as we travel going to our destiny. Call it heaven, call it eternal life, I call it union with God, our Creator. Okay? I hope this sharing of yours, this sharing of mine to yours, becomes meaningful, and more important than so, it becomes a guide into our preparation for the coming of the Lord Jesus. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.